The Nintendo Switch has games, lots of them as the joke goes. But contrary to what you may think, it has also plenty of great upcoming titles from Nintendo, third party and indie developers. In this video, we'll go over 20 of these, and let's just say you'll be impressed by Nintendo Switch's upcoming lineup in the coming years. So be sure to smash that like button and let's aim for 4,000 likes. Press that red subscribe button to turn it gray, and if you want to watch more videos like this one, then press that notification bell and again for all notifications. Now with that out of the way, let's get started. Number 20. Yo-Kai Watch 4. The HD, or if you prefer anime-like visuals and the new free-roaming overworld, is probably the greatest selling point of this yokai or monster evil spirit hunting experience. Its low placement might thus come as a surprise, but keep in mind that this is a game that has been out for over a year on the Japanese Nintendo Switch eShop, which still lacks a release window for a Western localization, despite confirmation that an English version of the game will arrive. I guess we just have to be patient. The same goes for Persona 5 Scramble, the Phantom Strikers, which shares the 20th spot, as it is also out on the Nintendo Switch in Japan or on the Japanese eShop, but with no Western localization in sight. Yes, Yo-Kai Watch 4 and Persona 5S could end up as 2021 titles, outside of Japan. Number 19. Immortals Fenyx Rising. The title of the game actually points to the playable character Fenyx, whose quest is to save the Greek gods from a dark curse. It is also worth mentioning that the art style has also been tweaked, and hopefully it is still coming to Nintendo Switch after the overhaul from the team behind the very solid Assassin's Creed Odyssey. The Seven Regions, Greek mythology premise, and battles of this open-world, third-person action-adventure game with ancient puzzles look rather promising, but due to the many uncertainties in regards to its development and Nintendo Switch release and performance, we have to sadly place it this low on the list. At least everything points to a Thursday, December 3rd release, so hopefully this year also on the Nintendo Switch. Number 18. Mario Kart Live Home Circuit. A Mario Kart augmented reality experience on the Nintendo Switch, which also comes with a very well-designed RC car that can be controlled from the Nintendo Switch, and when it is not in use and depleting its 1.5 hour long battery on 150cc, it can be proudly displayed on our shelves. Sign me up. Naturally, this isn't a proper Mario Kart, but more of a fun way of immersing if you have the space or a living room set up for it. The entry fee of $100 is another deal, should make it worth it. Still, I have to wonder how long it will take until we get bored of playing the game in our living rooms after October 16, 2020. Number 17. Puyo Puyo Tetris 2. Puyo Puyo and Tetris turned out to be a crossover made in heaven. Frantic puzzle gameplay is the name of the game, and in this package you can combine to your heart's content. Well, in December, as this is a follow-up that I know plenty of you have been looking forward to. The description of the game speaks for itself. Match 4 or more same colored Puyos, or complete a line of blocks to clear them from your board and dump garbage into your opponent's game. And that is the great charm of this franchise, with both offline local and online multiplayer. And the sequel comes with new characters, a new story mode, and overall improvements to the few shortcomings found in the original. Number 16. Pikmin 3 Deluxe. Pikmin 3, the big Wii U to Switch Deluxe port of 2020. But luckily, there is more that drops on October 30th than the classic Wii U Pikmin experience, since the deluxe version of the game includes new side story missions, co-op play in story mode, and all DLC stages added to the Wii U version for free. This and more make Pikmin 3 Deluxe a solid buy and entry on this list. Then why only the 16th spot? Simple, we're not Pikmin fans, and I'll be the first to admit that this franchise is simply not for me. I'm certain that this game would be higher on the other list, but sadly, not on ours. Number 15. Little Nightmares 2. Little Nightmares was a perfect example of a horror adventure game confronting you with classic nightmares of our childhood. Now, the sequel is also coming to the Nintendo Switch on February 11, 2021, and it does look very promising and frightening at the same time, with a new quest where this time it is up to the new protagonist, Mono, to save Six, the protagonist of the original Little Nightmares. Together they will try to make it out alive and survive the horrors that await. Hopefully, we'll still be in the mood for horror in February after the year of horrors 2020 is over. Number 14. LEGO Star Wars The Skywalker Saga. Time for another early 2021 game, and this one was delayed out of 2020. But then again, having a campaign that covers all 9 movies of the Skywalker saga in one LEGO game is no small feat to accomplish. But the wait will be worth it, as this will be one of the first LEGO games allowing you to play in a non-linear order. In other words, we'll be able to choose which Star Wars movie we want to play at any moment to complete the 5 story missions found in each of the 9 movies. So in total, 45 levels with plenty of playable characters and even more LEGO humoristic touches to the complete saga. Number 13, Doom Eternal. The follow-up to 2016 Doom was actually supposed to launch on the Nintendo Switch simultaneously last year, but then it was delayed to March 2020. Well, the PS4, PC and Xbox One versions. The Rip, Tear and Hookshot masterpiece of 2020 with a solid first-person campaign is another Nintendo Switch uncertainty. Luckily, the port is being prepared by the masters of Switch third-party optimization, namely Panic Button, and id Software, the developer of Doom Eternal, has assured that we will get a release announcement pretty soon. Well, we are in September, so hopefully we'll still get to play the best first-person shooter of 2020 in 2020 on the Nintendo Switch. Number 12, Bravely Default 2. It's time for the Bravely Default RPG to move from the 3DS to the Nintendo Switch, and what a jump it will be. Developed in Unreal Engine 4, offering a brand new world, a new set of 4 playable characters, and most of all a brand new story and adventure with no connections to Default and Second Enlayer. The turn-based battles, however, return. So Octopath fans, this is your holdover until we hopefully get a sequel to Octopath Traveler. Now it remains to be seen if Bravely Default 2 will release as promised in 2020, but until then we at least have the free Switch eShop demo. Number 11, Overwatch 2. Overwatch on the Nintendo Switch in 2019 was a mixed bag. On one side, it provided a solid Overwatch experience, but at the other, it was held back by framerate issues and a long list of other technical issues. So our hope is that these will be addressed and that the Nintendo Switch with the sequel gets the first-person Overwatch 2 experience that we deserve. The game has currently no release window, but 2021 might be a possible year since the game is running an upgraded version of the original's game engine. So hopefully the Switch version will not disappoint and provide the Game of the Year 2016 experience that we didn't get back in 2019. Number 10, No More Heroes 3. Suda51 got his wish, and No More Heroes will become a proper trilogy this year unless it is delayed to 2021. Hopefully that will not happen, as we have been waiting over 10 years for a proper sequel to No More Heroes 2 Desperate Struggle. Still, Travis Touchdown is back with his beam katana and ready to once again make his way up the ranks in Santa Destroyed, though this time by defending the city from an alien invasion. The frantic and mature gameplay of the original No More Heroes game is back and in Unreal Engine 4, and I can't wait to play it. Number 9, Shin Megami Tensei 5. First revealed at the 2017 Nintendo Switch presentation, the wait for this game has been incredibly long, but will finally end in 2021. Now, the Nintendo Switch is also getting the HD remaster of Shin Megami Tensei 3 Nocturne, but everyone's eyes are set on Atlus' next big JRPG project after Persona 5, the Nintendo Switch exclusive Shin Megami Tensei 5. Not much is still known about the gameplay apart from the Tokyo and Demon Nightmare setting, but it is being designed as a hybrid of Nocturne and 4, so it will be interesting to see how well this very promising game performs. Number 8, Hollow Knight Silksong. No doubt the most anticipated indie title on the Nintendo Switch, and for a good reason, as Hollow Knight was nothing short of a masterpiece. If 2D Metroidvania action-adventure games are your jam, then Silksong will, much like the original, be the perfect fit for you. This time, however, we play as Hornet, who will throughout her adventure acquire a number of powerful moves to overcome the dangers and bosses that await. The only real bummer about Silksong is that we have no release window yet, so hopefully 2020, but let's be real, it would more likely be in 2021, as Team Cherry needs their time to create another indie masterpiece. Number 7, Genshin Impact. This game is mostly known for two things: being a Breath of the Wild clone and being controversial. But you know what? It is a mighty good clone with controls, abilities and mechanics that will make any modern Zelda fan feel right at home in this massive open world third person action adventure game. In fact, I've had the pleasure to play the beta on PC and was very impressed. So much so that it brought it all the way up to the 7th spot on this list. The game is coming to the Nintendo Switch, it is just that we don't know when. The other versions are probably already out by the time you're watching, so likely we'll end up with another Switch 2021 title in this case. But then, it better come out before one of the other entries on this list. Number 6, Super Mario 3D World plus Bowser's Fury. This underrated Mario game would no doubt have made top 5 if it wasn't for the fact that it is 2021's first Wii U to Switch port. Still, it makes a 6th spot as Bowser's Fury appears to be a major expansion added to the game. We still have little information about the new cat-themed area, but it looks like it will deliver the same solid experience of the main game and post-game. A February 12, 2021 release date for this jazzy and classy up to 4-player experience with playable Mario, Luigi, Toad, Peach and Rosalina is the perfect way to start the big Nintendo year of 2021. Number 5. New Pokemon Snap. If you thought an over 10-year wait for the third proper entry in the No More Heroes series is horrible, then try an over 20-year-long wait for a new Pokemon Snap. And very fittingly, this is also the title for the second true entry in this first-person photo rail shooter simulation. The game's visuals are absolutely stunning, and based on the reveal trailer, it appears that Bandai Namco will deliver the most impressive-looking Pokemon game experience to date. Now, we just need a release date. Hopefully still 2020. Once again, it is more likely to be in 2021. At least that isn't the case for the next entry. Which is number 4. Super Mario 3D All-Stars. Finally, after years of waiting after Super Mario Odyssey, we get to play the other 3D Mario masterpieces on Nintendo Switch. Super Mario 64, Sunshine and Galaxy. Galaxy 2 apparently doesn't exist to Nintendo, well, at least until the limited release of Super Mario 3D All-Star ends in March 2021, and then maybe they go on to reveal a Mario Galaxy collection. Sadly, the reason why this collection doesn't make the podium even with a September 18, 2020 release is simple. It could have been so much more. Since Super Mario 64 is only in 720p docked and not in widescreen even. Super Mario Sunshine, despite being widescreen and in 1080p, still lacks the Corona Mountain missions. And Super Mario Galaxy is, well, Super Mario Galaxy but in HD. Still, $60 for free 3D Mario classics is great value. Pick it up physically if it's still available. It will become a collectible. Number 3. Bayonetta 3. Haha, very funny. But you know what? This time the number of the game and placement of the game makes perfect sense. The hack and slash series has found its permanent home on the Nintendo Switch, and we know that Hideki Kamiya, after seeing Devil May Cry 5, wants to surpass it by delivering the best installment in the Bayonetta series and turn Bayonetta into one of the greatest video game trilogies of all time. Since Bayonetta 2 was superior to Bayonetta, and we know that Kamiya is capable of making Bayonetta 3 his best. For now, we have no idea when the game will release, but it has been in development since at least December 2017, so a 2021 release seemed to be likely. We wish that would also be the case for... Number 2. Metroid Prime 4. Oh, Metroid. Still waiting for a brand new installment that will let us forget Other M once and for all. And it seems that this franchise, despite its excellent space exploration and combat qualities, is simply cursed. Forced to restart development 1.5 years after the E3 2017 reveal, making a 2021 release impossible. On the plus side, development was at the beginning of 2019 handed to the legends at Retro Studios, who welcomed the project with open arms, and has since gone on a hiring spree, bringing in some of the greatest talents in the video game industry to continue the first-person adventure trilogy that has waited for its fourth installment since 2007. No doubt, this will be one of Nintendo Switch's by far best games, but it misses the top spot on our list too. Actually, before we go to number 1, I want to bring up one honorable mention, since the game hasn't been properly revealed, only teased, and that is Monolith Soft's new IP that they are working on. We have seen concept art, it looks very promising, but we have no idea what the title of the game is, when it will launch, or if the concept will even turn into reality or just used as inspiration for a franchise that they will reveal. But keep in mind, if we actually had a name, a title, and some actual footage, then it definitely would have been on this list. But now, let's get to number 1, the sequel to Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild, or simply Zelda Breath of the Wild 2, title pending. The sequel to the unrivaled game of the year 2017, which did not only revolutionize the Zelda franchise thanks to the organic open-air concept, but the open-world game genre in general. The pressure on Breath of the Wild 2 is thus no doubt massive, as it is the first console Zelda game since Majora's Mask to follow up a Hyrule adventure. Not only that, it is reusing the same game engine, art style, Link and Zelda, and the open air of Hyrule. Still, if there's one team that is able to expand, refine, improve, address shortcomings, and grant us the best Zelda adventure and Ganondorf confrontation to date, then it is the Zelda team. Very likely, Zelda Breath of the Wild 2 will be a 2021 release for the 35th anniversary of The Legend of Zelda, and it needs it, as expectations have never been higher than for this sequel, and hence why it is also number 1 on our list of top 20 upcoming Nintendo Switch games. Do you agree with this list filled with big Switch games, or are there some other games you think deserve to make it in? Tell us in the comment section down below. And obviously, like the video, as we wanted to restore confidence in the Switch games lineup with this video. If you want more videos like this one, then be sure to turn that red subscribe button grey and press that notification bell and again for all notifications. We are very close to 265,000 subscribers, so let's get there and begin the big push for 300,000. Finally, a big thanks to all our patreon.com/commonrealm patrons, and in particular our royal producer Charles Shash. Anyway, thank you so much for watching, and enjoy one or both of these two awesome videos.